This is part 4 of a series on XGBoost. In this video, we will look at the training and the prediction process of XGBoost classification. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English, and my voice was AI-generated, text-to-speech. Until the last video, we looked at the regression. But from this video, we will look at the classification. Let's look at the training and the prediction process through a simple example. In the next video, we will derive the formulas used in this video and analyze the classification algorithm in detail. Let's take a look at the exact greedy algorithm for classification. We'll look at the training process first and then the prediction process later. For regression, we use the initial prediction to calculate the residuals and learn the residuals to estimate the next prediction. And we keep repeating this process. However, for classification, as we saw in GBM, we use the initial prediction to compute the initial logodds F0 and the residuals R. We then use these residuals to estimate the new logodds, and then convert the logodds values into probabilities. And we keep repeating this process. In the case of regression, y hat is directly estimated from the residuals. But in the case of classification, logodds is estimated first from the residuals, and then y hat is estimated from the logodds. The reason for this process is that in classification, the y hat is bounded to 0 and 1. For regression, y is unbounded from the negative infinity to the positive infinity. And the residuals are also unbounded. However, in classification, y is bounded to 0 and 1, while the residuals are unbounded from the negative infinity to the positive infinity. We cannot directly estimate the bounded y value from the unbounded residuals. Therefore, we first estimate the unbounded logodds f and then use the logistic function to convert the logodds to the y value. For this reason, the classification is a bit more complex than the regression. Let's use this data as an example. The source of this example is XGBoost Part 2 on YouTube StatQuest. There is only one feature X and a target class Y for binary classification. Class 0 means no and class 1 means yes. This is very simple data consisting of a total of 4 pieces of data. In step 1, we estimate the initial value of the target Y. Then we calculate the logodds, F0, for the initial prediction and calculate the residuals. By default, we set the initial prediction for all data points to 0.5. And we use this formula to calculate the logodds, F0. The initial logodds F0 is 0. Next, we calculate the residuals as the difference between the actual y values and the initial predictions. The initial residuals for each data point are as follows. The root node contains the residuals and is split into child nodes to create a tree. Step 2 calculates the similarity score for the root node. The formula for calculating score is as follows. The numerator is the square of the sum of the residuals. For regression, H is 1. However, in classification, H is as follows. And the lambda is a regularization constant. Here the lambda is set to 1. Now let's calculate the score for the root node. Again, the numerator is the square of the sum of the residuals. The denominator is calculated this way. The H value of the first data point is like this. Since the initial predicted value is 0.5, it is calculated like this. The h of the second data point is calculated this way, and the third and fourth data points are also calculated in the same way. And the lambda is 1. The initial predictions are all equal to 0.5, so all data points initially have the same h value. This calculation gives the root node a score of 0. In step 3, we use all split point candidates in the feature x to split the root node. We then calculate the scores of each child node. Here, we will only use the candidates for points A and B. The split point A uses the median value of 15, between 12 and 17 to split the root node. With split point A, the left node is assigned 3 data points, and the right node is assigned 1 data point. The root node is split like this. For split point B, 2 data points are assigned to the left and 2 to the right. Now let's use the above formula to calculate the scores of the left and right nodes, respectively. The left node has a score of 0.14, and the right node has a score of 0.2. For tree B, the left and right nodes both have scores of 0. The larger the sum of the scores of the child nodes, the better this split is likely to be. Tree A is better than tree B. Step 4 calculates the gain using the scores before and after the split calculated on the previous page. The formula for calculating the gain is as follows. The sum of the scores of child nodes after splitting minus the score of parents node before splitting, and then minus the pruning constant, gamma. We have 2 split candidates, trees A and B, created on the previous page. We then calculate the gain for each split. Before splitting, the root node has a score of 0. And after splitting, the scores of each child node are as follows. The sum of the scores of each child node after splitting minus the score of the parent node before splitting, and then minus pruning constant, gamma. Then we get 0.24. For tree B, the same calculation yields negative 0.1. Tree A has a larger gain, so we discard tree B and choose tree A. The gamma used 0.1 here. If the gain is less than 0, the parent node will not be split. If tree A's gain is negative 0.05, this is also greater than tree B's gain. However, since the gain is negative, the node will not be split. This is because there is no benefit from the split. What controls this is the pruning constant, gamma. The larger the gamma, the less likely it is that the node will split. In other words, pruning occurs a lot. This is the role of gamma. Since we selected tree A in step 4, we continue to split tree A to a predefined depth. This time we will use C and D as the split point candidates. Tree C is created like this, and tree D is created like this. Again, we calculate the gain for the split C and D to find a better split. Calculate the scores of each child node in the same way as in step 3. The score of the parent node before splitting is 0.14. The sum of the scores of each child node after splitting minus the score of the parent node before splitting and minus pruning constant gamma, the gain is 0.63. Calculating the gain of the split D in the same way yields negative 0.04. Again, tree C has greater gain, so we discard tree D and choose tree C. If the depth of the tree is set to 2, tree C will be the final tree of the first iteration round. Step 6 calculates the output values for the leaf nodes of the final selected tree. The formula for calculating the output value is as follows. The formulas for calculating the score and the output value will be discussed in detail in the next video. In this video, we'll use this formula as it is, where J is the leaf node number, I is the data point number, and this notation represents the data points belonging to the leaf node J. Use this formula to calculate the output values for the leaf nodes of tree C. Then we get the following results. The leaf node numbers J are 1, 2, and 3. This tree was generated in the first iteration round, where y hat t-1 represents the initial prediction, y hat 0. Since the initial prediction for the data points belonging to the first leaf node is 0.5, the output value is negative 0.4. The output value of the second leaf node is 0.67. And the output value of the third leaf node is also negative 0.4. Step 7 uses these output values to estimate the new y hat. As mentioned earlier, we do not estimate the y hat directly, but first estimate logodds f. New logodds can be estimated this way. The initial logodds value f0, the learning rate eta, and the output value are used. Let's estimate the new logodds for the first data point. The initial logodds f0 is 0, and the learning rate eta is set to 0.8. Since the first data point belongs to the first leaf node, the output value is negative 0.4. Therefore, the new estimated logodds f1 becomes negative 0.32. Now we can use the logistic function to convert the logodds f to y hat. The y hat for the first data point is 0.42. This is the new prediction for the first data point. The initial prediction of 0.5 has been updated to 0.42. In the same way, new predictions for the remaining data points are also calculated. Step 8 computes new residuals using the new predictions. Let's calculate the new residual for the first data point. Subtracting the new predicted value of 0.42 from the actual target y value of 0 results in negative 0.42. This is the new residual for the first data point. In the same way, all the residuals for the remaining data points are calculated. Then the residuals are also updated like this. As the iteration progresses, the size of the residual gradually decreases, and the new predictions also get a little closer to the actual y values. Step 9 follows steps 2 through 5 to create a new tree using the new residuals. This is the tree generated from the second iteration round. The tree generated using the initial residuals by the first iteration round was like this. In this way, we compute all output values for the leaf nodes of the new tree. And in the next step, we use these output values to predict another new y hat. Then we use the newly predicted y hat to calculate the next residuals. The size of the residuals continues to decrease, and the predicted y values become closer and closer to the actual y values. This process is repeated until the residuals are sufficiently small. This is the training process of XGBoost classification. This time, let's look at the prediction process. We can predict the target class of test data using the tree models created during the training process. The trees generated during the training process are as follows. And we have a test data point like below. We want to predict the target class for this test data point. First, estimate the logodds F of this test data. The logodds can be estimated using this formula. The initial logodds F0 is 0, and the learning rate, or the shrinkage factor, is set to 0.8. When we input this test data point into the first tree, since it belongs to the second leaf node, the output value is 0.67. When we input this test data into the second tree, since it also belongs to the second leaf node, the output value is 0.505. Therefore, the logodds F comes out to be 0.94. Now we convert this logodds F into probability. The logodds is 0.94, so the probability is 0.72. Since this is greater than 0.5, we predict the target class of this test data point to be 1. If the drug dosage is 20, the logodds F will be negative 0.59. And Y hat will be 0.36. Since this is less than 0.5, we predict that the target class for this test data point is 0. This is the prediction process of XGBoost classification. In this example, we only perform 2 iterations to simplify the problem. But in practice, we iterate until the residuals are sufficiently small and multiple trees are generated. So far, we've looked at the training and the prediction process of XGBoost classification. In the next video, we will analyze the classification algorithm in detail through the contents of the paper.